On the previous turn, we have discussed the different kinds of quadrilateral, trapezium, kite, parallelogram, and its properties. So, let us today discuss exercise 3.3. This is the first question. Given a parallelogram A, B, C, D, complete each statement along with definition or property, whichever you have used. Now, AD equal. We have to tell AD will be equal to which side. Now, since the opposite sides of parallelogram, they are equal, and BC is opposite to AD, so AD will be equal to BC. Now, angle DCB, DCB, is this angle? And we know that the opposite angles of parallelogram, they are equal, so angle DCB will be equal to angle BAD, this angle. It will be equal to this angle. So, that is DAB. Now, OC equal. Since OC is a part of diagonal AC, and we know that the diagonals of parallelogram bisect each other. So, OA equal OC. So, OC will be equal to OA. Next is measure of angle DAB. DAB is this angle plus measure of angle CDA means this angle. Since AB is parallel to DC and AD is a transversal. So, and these are consecutive angles. So, their sum will be equal to 180 degree. So, because we know that adjacent angles of parallelogram are supplementary. Our next question. These are two parallelograms and we have to find the value of unknowns x, y and z. In the first figure, ABCD is a parallelogram and opposite sides of opposite angles of parallelogram, they are equal. So, angle D will be equal to angle B, that is 100 degree. So, Y is equal to 100 degree. And adjacent angles of parallelogram, they are supplementary. So, angle A plus angle B will be equal to 180 degree because they are adjacent angles. So, Z plus 100 is equal to 180 degree. So, we can find Z as 180 minus 100, that is 80 degree. And again, we apply the same property which we have used earlier. That is, opposite angles of parallelogram, they are equal. So, angle C is equal to angle A, that is X equal to Z, that is X is also equal to 80 degree. Next question. Here, P, let us name this quadrilateral as P, Q, R, S. Now, P and S, angle P and angle S, they are forming adjacent angles of parallelogram. So, their sum is 180 degree. So, we can find X as 180 degree minus 50, that is 130 degree. And opposite angles of parallelogram, they are equal. So, Y is also equal to X, that is Y is also 130 degree. Now, Z. Since PQ is parallel to SR and this RQ is transversal. So, Y and Z, they are forming alternate angles. So, they will be equal. So, Z is equal to Y, that is 130 degree. So, aaj ke liye itna hi bacho. Thank you so much.